Hey, welcome back to the Six Figure Mastermind. Now, if you've been watching our channel, you know that we've been talking about Dropbox before, and you know it's going to be an essential for your business, but you've got to start somewhere. So let's go through the tutorial of how to actually get it on your computer.
Hi, my name is Toni Soderquist, and I've just been hearing so much about Dropboxes recently, and I have heard they are cool and safe. I don't know for sure at all, but I'm just wondering how important are they?
Let's talk Dropbox. Okay, if you've watched any of our other videos, you've seen how Dropbox works, why you should use it, why it's good. You know, not just for your business, but even for your personal items, for photos and for documents and things you need to share, and also things that you need to share with your own devices, you know, maybe from your phone to your computer and vice versa. And maybe you have some coworkers that you need to share your documents with, and you're working on a collaboration or a product. You know, I have an Instagram account, and I love using Dropbox for my Instagram account because I can take super high quality photos with my huge, big, fat, you know, $10,000 camera, right? And I can put them on Dropbox, and then I can use Dropbox to send them over to my Dropbox app on my phone, and then I can post them on Instagram. Okay, so this is great for Instagram, great for all other businesses. You know, one reason you're going to want to do that for Instagram is because not all your photos on Instagram are going to come from your iPhone. You want them to be top quality, right? So we got to get them to your phone somehow without having to, you know, take your phone and plug it into your computer and sync everything up and wait for all that to download. I'm all about automation, and this is a great way to do it. So today we're just going to walk through a standard, very simple, easy tutorial about how to get Dropbox talking to your computer and actually on there and going, okay? So go ahead and next to this window, either right or left or wherever you want, open up a brand new browser so we can do this thing together. I'll walk you through it step by step. Okay, so you can see my screen right here. It's just dropbox.com, and this is the screen as I've already logged in. So if you don't have a Dropbox account, it's super easy to set one up. Do that real quick. If you need to pause the video to do that, go for it. But if you already are just signed in, this is what you're gonna see, okay? So this is a brand new screen right here. It's got very simple features. That's one of the things I love about Dropbox, is how the interface is clean, it's simple, it's just easy and user-friendly, and there's cute graphics of little puppies on there. That's fun. Okay, so if we go down to the bottom here, there's this little three-dot thingy. It says table overflow. If you click on that, you're going to see install. Now, you do need to have Dropbox installed on your computer, otherwise you're gonna be dragging and dropping from the internet to your hard drive and back and forth. If you just install it on your computer, it's gonna save you a ton of time. I mean, I'm all about automation, right? Just get things clear and automated from the get-go. So you're gonna click install, okay? Another tab is gonna pop up. Ta-da! Download Dropbox. Like I said, very easy, very straightforward, very simple. Click it. It's gonna start downloading to your computer. For this one, it's gonna say Dropbox Installer, EXE. If you're on a PC, you're gonna click on that. It may look different on a Mac. Forgive me, I'm not on my Mac. I know, don't worry about it. Okay, yes, you want to allow apps to make changes to your device. Click yes there. It's doing its initializing thing. It's installing. Again, if you're using a Mac, which I'm gonna be honest, I would rather be using a Mac. I'm on a PC today, so, you know, that's where we're headed. I've got some total brand loyalty to Mac. I use everything Apple, but I wanted to show you this as well. But this process is pretty much the same for both worlds. On a Mac, you're just gonna hit install, and you're gonna right click and just install it to your hard drive. Most computers will ask you, hey, are you sure you wanna trust this app from this developer? Don't worry about that. That's just the computer's way of keeping you safe, keeping your computer virus free, and just, you know, getting rid of all the junk that's on there. Heads up when you do that, because every time you download an app, it's going to ask you if, you know, it's okay with you that it has access to your hard drive. And a lot of apps that are fraudulent, they may or may not show that. So remember, whenever you're installing new software or new hardware, to just remember who it's from. And yeah, if it's obviously, if you're downloading from Dropbox, allow Dropbox. But if you suddenly see one pop up on your computer, I've had this happen to me, you know, half a dozen times, where I'll see, hey, this software wants your permission to install on the computer. And I'm like, I never went to that website. I don't know what you're talking about. So obviously my computer's doing me a favor and I'm going to click no on that. Okay. So we're just going to let this install and we won't waste your time. So we're just going to cut back to this as soon as that's done. Okay. Ta-da. It's on. And you can tell because usually it'll pop up this window that says set up Dropbox. This is just where you're going to configure everything and make sure it's all talking to the same account. The cool thing about having Dropbox right on your computer is that, once again, you won't have to sign in every time you use it, which is handy. And I'm just going to connect my account here. If you don't have a Gmail account, I don't know what platform you're using, but you're going to want to have a Gmail account because, just as this example is with Dropbox, a lot of people use Gmail accounts. A lot of businesses like Dropbox or MailChimp or any other software that you're going to be using or programs or apps that you're going to be using, they connect to Gmail. So get a Gmail account if you don't already have one, okay? Hey, congratulations! Your Dropbox is successfully installed. Now you can add your personal Dropbox. Woohoo! Awesome. So I'm going to go ahead and skip that. I don't really need to do that. Now it's going to say, welcome to Dropbox. We're going to click get started. Okay, Dropbox is actually a folder on your computer. So if I were to open up this little folder tab here, I'm going to see Dropbox, usually on the side there. On a Mac, it'll show up in this sidebar over on this side right here. Let's just go through this tutorial and see what it looks like. So we're going to click next. Put your files in Dropbox. See, this is why you want it on a computer. Once you put your file or your template or your video or whatever document, once you put it in the Dropbox folder on your computer is going to automate it for you. You don't have to say, now put this on the internet. It's now available with whoever has access to your Dropbox, whether you're accessing it through your phone or accessing it with another person or whatever. It's automatically done for you. That's why I love it. Okay, click next. Everything is Dropbox in private unless you want to share it. And you can drag and drop the first file in the Dropbox folder. Finish. Okay, now it's going to walk me over here. Ta-da! Linked to Marianne DeNovellis to Dropbox. Very cool. Okay, so now look over here. We've got Dropbox now as a separate file on our computer. All right? You can see the little open cardboard box symbol. So if I have anything on here, let's say, I have this recording of my mom and dad reading a story, and that's a huge treasure for me. Let's say I want to share that with all of my siblings. All I would need to do is click on this and drag it and move it to my Dropbox, okay? Okay, now we've got that in my Dropbox, and if I were to go to my Dropbox online, I'm gonna refresh that. If I were to go to my Dropbox online and go to my personal Dropbox, then I could then share that file with anyone that I wanted to. I could send that file to all my siblings and, you know, using their email addresses, and they would be able to open that up and see it and download it from Dropbox to their computer. So I can share it personally through, you know, for a family function or something that I'm doing in my own personal life, or I can use it to, you know, collaborate and share files and share PDFs and share documents so that everyone can see it. Once I put it in the Dropbox, I'll do a courtesy and send out an email or a text and say, hey, check your Dropbox. I just sent you this link or whatever it is. And then all of my team has instant access to it. So again, Dropbox is super easy to install, very simple to use. And you will find that most six-figure businesses and above are using this software. So go ahead and download it on your computer right now. Awesome. I hope that tutorial was helpful for you. So if there's anything else that you want to know to build your six-figure mastermind business, whether it's social media, whether it's online platforms, whatever you're wanting help with, leave me a comment below. I'd love to make a video especially for you. Hit the subscribe button. I'll see you tomorrow.